How's it going? So we're gonna be building a binary image uploader. So we're gonna take an image, right? Let's say basic, right? It will give us a preview. We're gonna send it to MongoDB as a string, as a binary string, okay? And then it's gonna be displayed in here. Okay, so let's do another one. Arrow. You see, now it's displayed. Now you can see that it's a binary string. So if you look at MongoDB, right? You see, it's a binary string. You can name this whatever you want. I don't know, string, whatever, right? Now, big note, okay? This will not work for large files. For large files, you're gonna have to chunk them, but you're better off using a completely different app. I'll link in the description below a video that is suited for large files, right? This is just for small, like 100 kilobytes files, okay? So this is how to do it. It's gonna be in the description below, so you can see. Okay, so let's start to build it. One sec, let me just quickly remove this. Yeah. Okay, I can close this. Do not need this stuff anymore. Okay. And then let's do binary images. Let's just do this. We just need to wait until it updates. Let me just, okay, done. Okay, let's open this in the Visual Studio Code. Now it's a little bit slow because of the because I'm recording. I don't know why. OBS is just affecting it for some reason. Okay, so the first thing we need dependencies. We need express mongoose course node mon. I think that's about it. This is done. Next, we need to create scripts, I think, right? So we do server node1 server.js. Now we need to create a file server.js. So this is basic Express setup. The only anything we're gonna add is going to be, of course, that's what we're gonna add. Ghost. Dogs, now we can launch it. So they should start. Okay. Listening on port 5000. I'm thinking, what should we do next? We probably want to connect our Mongo database. Next, alright, okay, so let's do standard connection to MongoDB. So we're gonna do utils, right? Now you can connect in any way you want to MongoDB. Let's call it, I don't know, one sec, I'll just think about it. Let's just do this. One sec, where's my code? For MongoDB connection. Now, I'm assuming you already know how to connect to Mongo, okay? Like, otherwise, this is not the video for connecting, for learning how to connect to MongoDB, right? Okay, so that's our connection. Next, we need to create a schema. So let's call it model. Oh, shite. We need to import this. Let's import this in here. Almost. Connect to Mongo. Wire. Details. Connect to Mongo. Oops. And then we need to run this thing, I think. They should say connected to Mongo. Okay, so now we're connected to database. Now we need to create a schema, so call it or whatever. Binary images. Now, we don't really need this Mongo Jumbo at all. Just I put strict false. So we can put anything we want. And then here we're gonna put, what we're gonna put in here? Let me see. Binary images? Yeah, let's just do this. Now you can put anything you want, it will automatically create it, if it doesn't exist. It's up to you. Okay, so now we need to import this thing. Schema. This can be named anything you want. Completely up to you. Acquire model. Okie dokes. So that's our kind of backend setup. We're just gonna do. So next thing we need is we need the client. So we're gonna do npx create React app latest. Call it client. I'm gonna pause and wait until it finishes. Okay. So now we need to go into client. Oops. To client npm install Axios. That's the only dependency we need. In here. Start it up. To do some cleaning up in the client side. We don't need this stuff anymore. Okay, so what's the best way we can do it? Image upload and preview. Okay, so what do we need to do? We need Axios for sure. Actually, I'll do it exactly the same as in this, so you don't get confused. So we're gonna need to do it then, what did I call it? Don't change. can do it without form if you want to. Did I do what? Yeah, I did what? So the first thing we need is we need const file set file state. Okay. We need to import get state. I think we need use effect as well. We need to preview. No, actually, I'm just gonna remove them for now, so you don't get confused. Okay, so we need to define our change function. Event the target files 0, I think. Now we need state, we need somewhere to save this file. Okay, so when we submit, oh yeah, we need to prevent default. Otherwise the form is going to submit. Oh no, we don't need, not on change. Okay, so this should give us, let's choose a file. So now we have a file inside the state. Okay. So next thing we need to do, we need to convert this file into a blob so we can display it in here. I'll show you in a sec, 1 second. Preview file. So it's gonna be image source. It's going to be preview. And we need to do a little bit of error handling. So if preview is true, then we want to display this. So we're gonna need the state in here. Okay, so what we need to do is we need to const show image blob, we call it. And to convert it, you need to use like this URL, create object URL, target files 0. We probably want to reuse this. Input when you are using something twice, it's a good idea to create a variable out of it. This is why I use it. Let's see. So we don't have to constantly. Okay. So now we're gonna console log. Image blob. We should be able to see this blob in here. Yeah, you see? That's the blob. So now we need to put this blob into set preview. Because look, if you just take this and put it into source in here, it's going to display, you see, now it's not going to, because you cannot see it anymore. We need it to be state. We need it to be state, otherwise it's not going to work. Now it's going to work. Basically, if you take this blob and put it in here, it's going to work. It's going to display. So you see, it's displayed now. So let's take something like, you see, there it is. I'm just showing you. So let's do this. Let's see, there it is. It's been displayed. So this is pretty much everything for preview. Next, we want to submit. This is going to be a long function, I think. Okay, so now we have two things, right? We have the blob, right, in the state. And we have the file inside the array. So now we need to convert the file into binary. Right, so this file here right now is a file, so we need to convert it into binary. Right, so the way to do that is just use this function here. You can copy and paste it from my file, which is here. You don't really need to know what it does, to be honest with you. It's already pre-made. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is let v64 file equals wait, and we call this function. And we pass file into it. This state here, okay? And then you'll see what it's going to return. we're getting the binary of this file. Everything else is easy. It's just save it into Mongo, extract it from Mongo, and put it into source. So if we take this thing here, okay, I'll show you, okay. Let's just make a fake state. Okay, let's just make a promise. Show file. Set show file. Your state. So, okay. So now look, if we just take set show file, if we put this string into a state, okay, it will show it. So let's say h1 show the file, and we do exactly the same, right? So if what did I call that thing again? Show file, okay. So if show file is true, this gigantic string into image source, it displays it. Okay, it displays it. So now all you have to do, now this is tutorial done. All you have to do is save this into Mongo database, extract it, and put it into here. That's it. Done. Okay? I think you can do it by yourself, but I'll do it with you anyway. So in here, when you click on submit, we also want to set file, okay, set file to null, and we want set preview. Just want to get rid of preview as soon as. So it's gonna work like this. We're gonna put basic, submit, and there it is. Let's do another one. There it is. Okay. Okay. So. We need an endpoint to put the file into the database. Okay, so it's gonna be post upload single files app. It's gonna be a post request upload request respond. I just saved it for myself. Okay, so we need to make it async, I think, right? I'm not doing any error handling, so you need to do that yourself, okay? So, gotta console. Spotify, maybe. Okay, let me hit this. Let me hit this endpoint real quick. 1 sec. So on submit, we need to. Okay, I don't need this anymore. Okay, so we need to create Axios post. I don't know which one you run it on, but I'll run it on this one. Survey URL. So now when I click this, this should be in our server. Yes. Oh my god, it's huge. Alright. So now we need to send this to MongoDB. This part here. So we're gonna do read schema dot. I don't remember how to. 1 second. I think it's create. Yeah, and then we're gonna call it bin. So now this should send the files here. So let's choose a file. Submit. Okay. Oh, this should be on our database now. Yeah, there it is. Shit, I should have called it. Otherwise you might get confused. Oh, I called it file bin. I called it like this. File bin. Yeah. I guess I need to change that. File bin. I'm just doing it so that it matches this. So you don't get confused, you know? Like, what the hell is going on? Binary image schema. Is that correct? Binary image schema, yeah. Okay. Okie dokie. Okay, so the second thing we need to do is we need to create an endpoint where we can fetch all the data. Okay, so let's create an endpoint. get request. It should be. Should it be a sync? We'll just have a look. Yeah, so commons data. So when we hit this endpoint, it should give us all of our data, right? So it's running 5000. Let's see. Yes, there it is. So there is one right now, right? There is one. Let's do another one. Let's do arrow. Now if we fetch, there should be two. Oh shit. Yeah, so there's two now. So now we just need to display it in here, and that's it, we're done. Okay, so we just need to fetch this endpoint, and that's it. So the way to do that is, let's do const fetch data. I don't think we need that. Okay. So that. Well, we're gonna need a. Well, let's call it that. Shit, what did I call this endpoint? Yeah, I called it data. So this image data, data. Okay, and we're gonna do this one time on start. We need to use effect. I'm just thinking there might be a better way to do it, but I'm not gonna do use memos and performance management in here. I'm just gonna do standard fetch stuff. Okay. So it's gonna fetch data and set it to. getting the data. Now we just need to display it in here. And then that's done. That's done then. Okay, so what is this? Okay. Wait. So data is now should be in our state, right? Yes. There's data, there's the file bin. And we have the ID as well. We can use it for a key. So now we go like this. So if data is true, data.map, let's destructure ID, file bin, I think, right? File bin. So they should display it. Oh. Yikes. Yikes, yikes, yikes. Yeah, we probably better for the device. And then we're gonna move the key to here. So it doesn't complain anymore. Okay. So now we see all the files. Honestly, that's kind of it. I think we just need to refetch. So when we add file, yeah, we need to refetch on submit. So on submit, we need to do this basically. On submit. Oh, it doesn't matter where you put it, honestly. Yeah, so you see. Let's do a tree. Oh, there's the tree. That's it. It's done. Let's do another basic. It should appear in here. Yeah, you see, so now there's five. And that's it. It's done. Now, again. This will not work for large files, so I think this file is slightly bigger. Let me see. Yeah, you see, so this is 269 kilobytes. Whereas this one is... What's the biggest out of them? I think it only goes up to 100 or something. Like you see, so if you put this one, submit, it will fail. And if you look why, it will sail. It will say that file is too big or something like this. Basically. So you see, it didn't upload at all. It says cores, blah blah blah, but the reality is just too big. So you need to split this file into a lot of kind of like a string that is sliced, right? Then it's going to work. But honestly, for large files, you want to do a different tutorial. I will link in the description below the tutorial you need to do for the large files. Okay. You can create like error handling saying that, you know, if return from the server is error, cancel the operation or whatever, right? But that's up to you. Okay, that's it. Take care.